We be the warriors, the most high sent, so you know there is no destroying us. Ordained from the womb, prophets back from the tomb to cast out all these false doctrines.
Time for y'all to wake up, man. Time for our people to wake up, repent, and come back to God. You blacks, Hispanics, and you so-called Native Americans, all the Israelites the Bible speaks of. We God's chosen people. Slavery in the Bible and slavery in Bible prophecy. It's time for y'all to wake the hell up. Give me Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 8. Time for our people to wake up and repent and come back to God as his chosen people. God only chose one nation of people on this planet Earth. One nation of people on that planet Earth, and that's you blacks. Read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 48. 5 and 8. If thou seest the oppression of the poor.
So the most I can look at that, see, y'all ain't even ready for none of that yet. Our people ain't ready for war. You got jumpers flying through the neighborhood. Y'all ain't prepared for no war when war break out. Time for our people to wake the hell up. Listen to this, read.
If thou seest the oppression of the poor.
So God said we see the oppression of the poor. So our people oppressed, right? We see the oppression, right? Read.
And violent perverting of the judgment.
He said violent perverting the judgment. We see violent perverting the judgment every day, right? And let's show you one way in the Bible they violently pervert judgment. Give me Zechariah chapter 11, verse 5. See, this Bible is the real book of life, and it's time for our people to wake up. God only gave this Bible to the Israelites. You are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. You are God's chosen people. Remember, your names were changed in slavery. The white man called you an African American. God called you Israelite, though, from the tribe of Judah. Read what you got, bro.
Zechariah chapter 11, verse 5.
So we're going to show you how they violently pervert, how they always pervert judgment. Read.
Whose possessors slay them and hold themselves not guilty.
Every time our possessors slay them, they slay one of us, they hold themselves not guilty. Every time our possessors slay us, they hold themselves not guilty. Read.
And they that sell them say, blessed be the Lord, for I am rich.
So that's how you see violently perverting the judgment. Go right back to what you was at, Ecclesiastes 5 and 8. It say, they who possess and slay them and hold themselves not guilty. Every time they shoot one of you down in the street, they say they not guilty. They came up with $4 million for that white man that shot up that black church in Charleston, South Carolina. They raised $4.2 million for him. They gave him a bulletproof vest, took him to Burger King because they hate you. They showing you that they hate you, but you love them though. They showing you that they your enemy, but you still want to be accepted by the other nations. We God's chosen people, and all nations hate us. Read what you got.
Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 8. If thou seest the oppression of the poor.
So he said, if you see the oppression of the poor, our people are oppressed. You can look around and you can see that our people are oppressed. You can look at our neighborhoods and you can see that our people are oppressed and poor. Read.
And violent perverting of judgment.
You can see the violent perverting of judgment going on. Every day you turn on TV, you see the violent perverting of judgment. They shoot your ass down in the streets every day. And what? Not guilty. Every time they shoot you down, not guilty. They hate you. You God's chosen people. They know who you are. Read.
And justice in a province marvel not at the matter.
God said marvel not at the matter, though. We see how this going on. How a lot of people do. They look, they ride back and forth. Our people don't even know who they are. Our people don't know their identity. Your identity got taken from you in slavery. Matter of fact, your identity got beat out of you in slavery. Give me Jeremiah 17, verse 4. Let's show you that your nationality. Let's show you that your identity, the one's going to be taken away from you. You can read about all this in the Bible. The Bible ain't nothing but a history book. We ain't no Christian. This ain't Christianity out here. This ain't your Christian pastor. This ain't your Christian church that you're in right now. You will never hear this come out of church, I guarantee you. You will never hear this come out of church. Your damn church is some frauds. There's some liars in your church.
Y'all know, hey,
the black woman always wearing blonde hair because she hated her. Give me Leviticus chapter 13, verse 3. Let me show y'all something about that blonde hair. That's how we see is our black women wearing this blonde hair. They hate themselves. They love the white woman, they hate them herself. God gave you woolly hair. God gave you hair like this. You see this? You see that black woman? When you stop perming your hair can grow like this. When you stop perming it. It can touch your back, no problem. When you do what God wants you to do. Putting all them damn chemicals in your head. Give me Leviticus 13, verse 30. Let me show you about blonde hair. Blonde hair is a plague according to God. Blonde hair is a plague according to God. But the black one won't put the white woman hair in their head. That's because y'all hate yourselves. Y'all hate your own damn selves. Read what you got.
Leviticus chapter 13, verse 30. Then the priest shall see the plague.
So it said the priest shall see what? The what?
The plague.
The priest shall see the plague. Read.
And behold, if it be in sight deeper than the skin, and there be in it a yellow thin hair.
Hold on, if it be in it a what?
If there be in it a yellow thin hair.
You see, a yellow hair is a plague in the Bible. But y'all want to throw some damn blonde hair in your head. Did you know Christ had woolly hair? God had woolly hair. Give me Daniel 7 and 9. God had woolly hair. He ain't no damn blonde hair. When y'all gonna wake the hell up and stop hating yourselves? You hate one another. Time for y'all to wake up and repent, come back to God. Y'all hate hearing the truth. When the truth come out, the first thing y'all like to say is that we judging you. Judge not ye be judged. Who taught y'all that? Who taught you that? Your damn pork chop eating pastor. Eating all that damn unclean food, wondering why your legs swollen up. Read.
Daniel chapter 7 verse 9. I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the Ancient of Days did sit.
So the Ancient of Days is talking about the Most High. Because he had no end of days or beginning of days, read.
Whose garment was white as snow.
God got a body. It said his garment was white as snow. In order to wear a garment, in order to put on a garment, what you got to have? You got to have a body. Read.
And the hair of his head like the pure wool.
It said the hair on his head like the pure wool. God don't got no damn straight hair like this damn devil right here. This the devil the Bible speaks of. This who shot up your damn church the other day. That let you know God ain't in them churches. Give me Acts chapter 17, verse 24. God ain't in them churches. God ain't in them churches. This is the devil the Bible speaks of. This ain't no damn Jesus. Jesus got woolly hair just like God got. Just like God gave us woolly hair. The damn hair our people hate. The damn hair you replace with the next person hair. The damn hair that you sit up there and go buy some hair instead of embracing what God gave you. Read what you got. And this a damn shame right here. Hold on, give me Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13 real quick. Give me Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13. See, this is why they sit up there and they legalize gay rights in all 50 states. They legalize gay rights in all 50 states. Read what you got, bro.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13.
Read what you got.
If a man also lie with mankind.
This God's law on homosexuality. Read.
As he lies with woman.
God said if a man lie with mankind, as he lie with woman. Read.
Both of them have committed an abomination.
He said, that's a damn abomination. What's going to happen to them if they do that, Reed?
They shall surely be put to death.
They shall surely be put to death. You're supposed to get put to death for them type of wicked-ass acts. But y'all believe every damn thing the white man say. Everything the white man say, oh, you one too, ain't it? Y'all, you one too. That's why she said I'm judging. I'm tired of y'all talking about I'm judging. Give me Ecclesiastes chapter 45, verse 26. Damn faggots, lesbos, every damn thing walking around here. The first thing they talk about you, judge. Our kids confused as hell growing up. Your kids at school learning how to be a damn faggot now. Learning how to be a lesbo. When the hell y'all gonna wake up, though? When you gonna wake up? Y'all stay in these damn neighborhoods. Y'all love being in the hood. We the only nation of people that glorify the hood. We the only nation of people that glorify the worst part of the city. God said y'all destroyed for a lack of knowledge. The Most High put you in the worst parts of the city to punish your ass. To sit up there to get you to repent. But you will not repent and you refuse to hear the word of God. We ain't your Christian pastor, so you ain't been getting the high and all that and a damn collection plate come around for your money. Read what you got. I'll tell y'all talking about we judge. Read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 45 and 26. God give you wisdom in your heart.
It said God give you wisdom in your heart to do what?
To judge his people.
God gave us wisdom to judge his people. So don't be talking about judge, let you not be judged. Your hands don't know. That's the only thing you know in the Bible. That's all you know to say, judge, let you not be judged. Who are you? What family on earth you belong to? What's your nationality? Who are your descendants? What do God call you in this Bible? Judge, let you not be judged. John 3:16, y'all know the same damn thing with y'all wicked asses. That's why a lot of our people gonna get put to death. A lot of y'all gonna get put to death. And the reason why you will not repent. I think that's in Luke, ain't it? Give me Luke chapter 6,
bring
verse
it
1.
Out, up.
Give me Luke 6 verse 1. Tell our people to wake up, man. I'm tired of seeing our people in the conditions they in. For real, though. Talking about you a damn Christian. You ain't no Christian. Y'all don't even know what Christian mean. I want somebody to come up here right now and tell me what Christian mean. You ain't no Christian. And this country ain't built up on Christianity. For real, though. Let me see if that's the correct scripture. I think it's Luke 11. Tell our people to wake up. I think it's Luke 11 and 3. Weak and ass, fool. Nah, okay, I don't want that. Give me 2nd Ed chapter 7, verse 20. Time for y'all to wake up. A lot of y'all gonna die because you despise the laws of God. You think the laws of God done away with? The laws of God ain't done away with. That's something your damn po-top E pastor told you. Your po-top E pastor don't even know who you are and won't tell you who you are. As a black man or a black woman out here right now, who you are, they can't even tell you. I don't think they can tell you. You judge it. Then you always got people to coming up making threats like we just gonna sit up here and take an ass whooping out here. We ain't your Christian pastor. We ain't taking no ass whooping. We gonna drag somebody down the street? Read what you got, bruh.
2nd Edges, chapter 7, verse 20. For there be many that perish in this life.
It said there be many that's gonna perish in this life. It's gonna be many people that perish in this lifetime. Why?
Because they despise the law of God.
Because they despise the laws of God. A lot of y'all gonna die because you despise the laws of God. Now when you go to Romans 6 verse 23, go there for me. A lot of y'all gonna die because you despise the laws of God. Transmission gone out in that. He brought the transmission out in his damn car. Because y'all wicked as hell. You're cunning, you're lustly. That's judgment right there. Buy a new car and a transmission burn out in. You can smell the fluid. Read.
Romans chapter 6, verse 23. For the wages of sin is death.
It said the wages of sin is death. Ooh. It said many gonna perish in this life because they despise the laws of God. Read that one more time.
Romans 6 and 23. For the wages of sin is death.
God said the wages of sin is death. A lot of y'all gonna die because you despise the law of God. A lot of y'all gonna die because you draw near with your mouth, but your heart far from it. A lot of y'all gonna die because you don't even know who you are. Read that again.
For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
It said the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Not that damn white devil right here. Hold that devil up. Let me see this devil. Not this devil right here. This ain't no Jesus right here.
Diablo.
This Diablo right here. This Blanco Diablo. This is not Jesus. The damn devil the Bible speaks of. Tell our people to wake up, repent, and come back to God. You Hispanics, you Israelites the Bible speaks of from the tribe of Issachar. You read Issachar in the Bible? You're an Israelite from the tribe of Issachar. Tell our people to wake up, man, and repent. Hey, go back, read that again, read.
Romans 6 and 23. For the wages of sin is death.
God said the wages of sin is death. A lot of y'all gonna die. You're gonna die because you despise the laws of God. For real, read.
But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Now give me Romans 3 verse 31. What we out here doing, we teaching our people who you are according to the Bible. You are God's chosen people. You are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. Slavery is in the Bible. Slavery is Bible props. You can read about the slave ships in the Bible. You can read about the yoke of iron being put on our neck in the Bible. You can read about our sons and daughters being given to another people in the Bible. Time for y'all to wake up, man. Have people sleep. Read.
Romans chapter 3, verse 31. Do we then make void the law through faith?
It said, do we make void the law through faith? A lot of y'all gonna die because you despise the laws of God. It is what it is. He said, do you make void the law through faith? Read.
God forbid. Yeah, we establish the law.
Now, we establish the law. Establish something means to make permanent. Establishing means to make permanent. We don't make void the law through faith. Tell bad people to wake up. I'm going to show you what happened when you are for not keeping God's law. Give me Deuteronomy 28. Verse 15. Tell bad people to wake up. You are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. God chose the people. Slavery is in the Bible. God gave us blessings for He gave us blessings for obedience. He said evil things gonna happen to you for being disobedient to my covenant. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou would not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So I said, we don't hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God. The voice of the Lord thy God is coming out this Bible right now. He said, if you don't want to hearken unto my voice, read.
To observe and to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the Most High told us, look, if we don't keep his commandments and we don't hearken to his voice, all these curses, all these evil things gonna come upon us and overtake us. Read.
Cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall thou be in the field.
He said, cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall thou be in the field. Who populate the worst parts? Who populate the poorest part of the city? Who populated the poorest parts of the city? Who packed in the ghettos and the projects in the public houses? God said, we don't keep his commandments, cursed shall thou be in the city. Read.
Cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall thou be in the field.
Who was cursed in tobacco fields? Cotton field, picking cotton, from sun up to sun down with no pay. Chucking corn, working on the rice plantations. He said, if we don't keep his commandments, cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall thou be in the field. Read on.
Cursed shall thou be the basket of thy store.
He said, cursed shall be thy basket in thy store. Where your business is at, black man? Where your chain of restaurants at? Where your chain of fast food restaurants at? Where your chain of grocery stores at? Where your business? You ain't own your own businesses in your community. Damn, Aram come here and put a gas station and get a corner store before you. You been here all your life. God said, if you don't keep my commandment, he said, cursed shall you be in the city, and cursed shall you be in the field. Meaning you're going to populate the poor parts of the city. You the only nation of people on the planet Earth that glorify the projects. Why couldn't the STD rate high in our community? Because y'all refuse to keep God's laws. Memphis number 3 for AIDS, and you still are running and wrong one of these damn women. You still out on damn near on the internet searching for ass. By ass in a heartbeat. We just seen a damn faggot walk past her in a dress, and some of you men do that too. You do that secretly at night. God said, curse shall thou be in the city, and curse shall thou be in the field. We were cursing the cotton field, the tobacco plantation, the rice plantation.
Bring it up,
we were chucking corn. Time for our people to wake the hell up and repent. Read.
Curse shall be the basket in thy store. Curse shall be the fruit of thy body and the fruit of thy land.
Why he said curse shall be the fruit of thy body? Give me from 1 Andrew chapter 5, verse 8. Let me show you why he said curse shall be the fruit of thy body. Talking about your damn kids. Your kids curse. Man, your kids wicked as hell. Black woman talking about she can do it by herself. Talking about she don't need the black man. Man, your damn kids some damn gangsters, some hoodlums, and thugs. Talking about you can do it without the black man. That's what's wrong with our women. You the only woman on the planet Earth that think you can do it without your man. Everybody else got their man. You think you can do it without your man, though. You let warfare fool you. You let warfare fool you, then your ass stay stuck in the projects all your life, raising up these badass kids. Your kids the ones who shooting the streets up, shooting the block up. Your kids the ones who selling dope and breaking their houses. But you thought you could do it by yourself. You can do it. I can do it by, I don't need no man. You the only damn woman on the planet Earth that sit up there and say you don't need no man. Because you got the white man warfare. You got the white man food stamp. You got the white man Section 8. Talking about you can do it by your damn self. Sit your ass down somewhere. That's why these damn kids straight up. Let me show you what God called your damn kids in the Bible. Read.
2 Exodus chapter 5, verse 8. There shall be a confusion also in many places.
It is a confusion in many places. When a man lay down with a man, that's confusion. When a woman lay down with another woman, that's confusion. But for some reason, y'all don't think it's confusion. Y'all think it's a sexual orientation. Y'all think it's a sex. It ain't no damn sexual orientation. That's just like me trying to take a damn plug and that's like me trying to take two plugs and put them together. That's why when you go to and anybody that know anything about electronics, you got the female plug, you got the female socket, and then you got the damn male. You stick the male inside the female. That ain't hard to understand. So I said, what?
Yes, sir.
And y'all ain't ready for no war. Y'all is not ready for war. Y'all ain't ready for no war. Y'all gonna be riding around disobeying God's laws, rejecting the word. They're gonna get to jumping at these damn things one day. One day they're going to be jumping out of. That's the second one that flew through here. They don't get to jumping after each other one day. Y'all ain't ready for war. Y'all is not prepared. Y'all is not ready for the end times. For real, though. A lot of y'all going to die. For real. You're going to die. And the reason why you're going to die, first of all, you don't know who you are. And you wicked as hell. You love breaking God's laws. You don't got no problem with breaking God's laws. You're going to get put to death. Especially you blacks and Hispanics. Because you are the Israelites, the Bible speaks of. You are God's chosen people. You did go into slavery for breaking his covenant. God is only dealing with you. You the only nation of people. Why you think you get punished? Why can you think so much evil always happening to you? Why you think so much evil always happening to you? Because God putting a foot in your ass. He's trying to get you to repent. But you don't want to repent. And then I come out here and preach like this. Oh man, he can't be sent by God. Throw your head down somewhere. Read what you got.
2 Exodus chapter 5, verse 8. There shall be a confusion also in many places.
It says it's going to be a confusion in many places. Look at it now. Women land with women. Man land with man. That's confusion. The hell you mean? Your kids growing up confused as hell. Your damn little boys going to start walking in the house with other little boys. Y'all going to think they just been, you going to think they just going to play. They're going to be in a damn pack doing God knows what. He said it should be what?
Confusion in many places.
There's going to be a confusion in many places. It's going on right now. That's what Babylon means. This Babylon the Great we've been in. This the great confusion right here. This the great confusion. You in Babylon the Great. Talking about some damn Arab. And over there in Iraq is Babylon. Now you in Babylon right now. You in spiritual Sodom. How did the Most High destroy Sodom and Gomorrah the first time? The Most High destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah with fire. He said, what?
There shall also be confusion in many places.
He said, it's going to be a confusion in many places. Woman land with woman, man land with man. Your damn white man, he trying to get right so he can marry his damn cow. He trying to get right so he can marry his dog. And some of y'all going to be following right along behind him. Trying to marry your damn dog, your pit bull, read.
And the fire shall be off. Sent out again.
Bring it out up.
And the wild beasts shall change their places.
Y'all ever been seeing wild beasts change their places? You seeing whales bank on the shore? Wild beasts have started to change their places. You seeing birds in people's backyard? You seeing snakes everywhere? Read on.
And minstrels women shall bring forth monsters.
God said minstrels women shall bring forth monsters. The black woman can't raise the kids by herself. I know she thinks she can do it by herself. Black woman, you can't do it by yourself. It is what it is. You need a man in your life. And when you say you're doing it by yourself, you ain't doing it by yourself. You're doing it with the white man help. You're doing it with the white man government assistance, his food stamp, his welfare, his public housing. Time for y'all to wake up and repent and come back to God. Give me Ecclesiastes 7:7.
Bring it out, up.
Time for our people to repent. You are the Israelites, the Bible speaks of God's chosen people. God only love you. Yeah, I said, yes, God is a racist. Because God only loved one nation of people on the planet Earth. He loved you so much that he sent his only son to die for you. Not die for everybody. Die for you blacks and Hispanics. That's it. You blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans. That's the only person Christ died for. Because y'all wicked as hell. Y'all wicked. Read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 7. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
It says surely oppression makes a wise man mad. When y'all gonna start getting mad? That's how you know a lot of our people lack wisdom. You see oppression going on. You see the oppression of the poor going on. A lot of y'all lack wisdom. Give me the Hosea 4:6.
Bring it out, up.
It says, surely oppression make a wise man mad. Ain't y'all tired of being oppressed? Ain't you tired of looking at your damn neighborhood looking like this? Ain't you tired of seeing how people dress the way they dress? Time for y'all to wake the hell up. You God's chosen people, the Israelites. God only love you. God is a racist. We don't care about all the other nations being a racist because God a racist. Damn right, I'm a racist. I only care about my people. I only care about the Israelites. That's it. What the hell with everybody else? They don't care about us. They never showed us that they love us. Read this, read.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
God said my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. You talking about the Israelites. You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. He said, you destroyed for a lack of knowledge. You the only people on the planet Earth that don't be trying to get no damn knowledge. The word of God coming out right now, y'all will turn up your heart, you'll roll up your windows and turn up your music. Matter of fact, I'm going to tell you what he said our people wise to do. Give me Jeremiah 4:22. He said, my people destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Our people the only people on the planet Earth that ain't trying to get no wisdom. Time for y'all to wake up, repent, and come back to this Bible. Come back to God. Come back to your God. Y'all don't even know who your God is. Read.
Jeremiah 4:22. For my people is foolish.
God said, my people is destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Then he said, my people is foolish. He said, my people is foolish, read.
They have not known me.
God said, my people foolish and they have not known me. God said, my people don't know me. Y'all think that's God. You don't even know God. How do you get to know God? Give me 1 John 2:3. He said, my people is foolish and they have not known me. Give me 1 John 2:3. How you get to know God? All y'all talking about, I know God. I got, especially the black woman. She loves to say she know God. She loves to say she got a personal relationship with God. Talking about you married to Jesus. Your whore's ass ain't married to Jesus. Jesus don't want no whore. Read what you got.
1 John 2:3. And hereby we do know that we know him if we keep his commandments.
It's like, this is how we know that we know God, if we keep his commandments. But go right back to what you was saying in Jeremiah 4:22. It said, hereby we do know that we know him when we keep his commandments. So if you're sitting up there talking about you know God and you ain't keeping none of his commandments, you a liar. And I'm tired of you black women talking about you married to God. God married to Jesus. Jesus ain't going to be married to no hoe. I'm just going to tell y'all top. Read.
For my people is foolish.
God said, my people is foolish. That's Jeremiah 4:22. You foolish to be sitting around here talking about you married to Jesus. You ain't married to no Jesus. Read.
They have not known me.
He said, my people is foolish. They have not known me. Why? Because you ain't keeping his commandments. You don't know the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. You don't even know your identity. Your identity was changed in slavery. They beat your identity out of you. All you blacks riding around right now, you got your slave master last name. Do your research, talking about some ancestry.com. It's going to go right back to a white man that owned you. It's going to go right back to that white man that owned your ass. Read that again.
Jeremiah 4:22. For my people is foolish.
God said, my people is foolish, read.
They have not known me.
The only way you get to know God is keep his commandments. Y'all don't keep commandment number one. You hate each other. That's why black on black crime high in our community. Our men, the only men on the planet Earth that call them women, call their women out their name. We call our women dots. The Chinese man don't call the Chinese woman a dot. The Arab man don't call the Arab woman a dot. We call our women bitches and whores in our routes. You don't hear the other nations doing that. God said, my people is foolish. He said, you have not known me. Read.
They are sottish children.
He said, y'all some hard-headed, knucklehead, sottish children. Wicked as hell. You the most wickedest nation on the planet Earth now. You have surpassed the evil of the white man. The KKK wrote you a damn thank you letter thanking you for shooting and killing each other on the streets. That's beautiful when the damn KKK write you a thank you letter. Talking about y'all some damn gangsters. Y'all ain't no gangsters. Y'all soft and weak as hell. We know you soft and weak as hell. You damn black men won't stand up for nothing. You won't stand up and rise up against oppression. We got the solution to get us out of this. Right now, we got the solution right here. You black men don't want no solution, though. You like it just like it is. That's why a lot of y'all gonna die just like it is. Read that again.
For my people is foolish.
God said, my people is foolish. Talking about you blacks and Hispanics. He said, my people is foolish. You the Israelites, the Bible speaks of. Read.
They have not known me.
He said, you ain't known them. Because you won't keep commandment number one. The only way to say you know God is to keep his commandments. Read.
They are sottish children.
He said, y'all sottish children. Y'all hard-headed. Y'all don't care about nothing and nobody but yourself. That's why a lot of our people going to get put to death. Read.
and they have none understanding.
He said, you don't got no understanding. You don't got no understanding of the Bible. You don't got no wisdom. You think you got a little wisdom. You went to the white man educational school. You went to college for 4 years thinking you got some wisdom. You went to college for 4 or 5 years thinking you got some wisdom. You don't got no damn wisdom. You got a big ass student loan. You got debt. That's what you got. You got some debt. Some of y'all won't pay y'all debt off to the rest of your life. Time for y'all to wake up. Read on.
They are wise to do evil, but to do good, they have no knowledge.
What's up, bro? You got any questions? Let me show you something, bro. You know who you are according to the Bible. I just had a young man just say he don't know who he are. Why? Because y'all black men ain't teaching him. You older black men can't teach the younger black men who they are. Look at this sign, bro. God calls us this right here on this side. Your slave master called you dead on that side. Where you at? Who are you? What do God call you, bro? What do God call you, young brother? Judah? Judah. God called you Judah. All praise to the Most High. Give me Jeremiah 14 and truth. Now let me show you that Judah is black according to the Bible. This young man right here said he want to learn his nationality. The rest of our people ride back and forth past, can't pull over, been walking past us, can't come up here. That's why your ass lost right now. That's why you a lost nation of people. You a lost nation of people. Why? Because you don't know who you are. Listen to this, bro. What tribe you from again, according to God? He said he from the tribe of Judah. Now let's see what kind of the tribe of Judah is in the Bible. Read.
Jeremiah chapter 14, verse 2. Judah mourneth. And the gates thereof languish.
It said Judah in mourning right now. One nation of people in mourning. One nation of people oppressed. One nation of people poor, bruh. Us. We in mourning. We oppressed. We poor. It said Judah mourning, read.
They are black unto the ground.
What color, Judah?
They are black unto the ground.
The tribe of Judah black. We God's chosen people.
Bring it out!
We went into slavery for breaking God's laws. You'll never hear this in the church, bruh. The churches ain't gonna teach you this. Why? Because they want your money. Your churches want your money. You damn black women go to church every Sunday and don't know one scripture. But John 3:16, and judge lets you not be judged. Let me show you something. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. God gave us blessings for obedience. God said, if you keep my commandments, he said you're gonna be a blessed people, and I'm gonna set you over all nations on the planet earth. But he said, if you break my commandments, your evil things gonna happen to you. He said, you're going to be a cursed people, and all type of evil things going to happen to you. Listen to this, read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou would not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So the Most High God said, look, we don't want to listen to his voice, read.
To observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the Most High told us, look, he told the Israelites, them people on this sign. If y'all don't keep my commandments, all these evil things gonna happen to you. Give me verse 32. You tell me if this happened or not. Read.
Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given into another people.
Did not that happen? Our sons and daughters was given to another people. They happened to the Hispanics too. Their people was given to the conquistadors. Their people were given to the conquistadors. They spoke Hebrew at first. And then they sat up there and changed their language. They beat just like they beat our language and our nationality out of us. They beat their language and nationality out of them too. Listen to this. He said what?
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
It happened to us. Our sons and daughters were given to another people, read.
And thine eyes shall look and fail with the longing for them all the day long.
When they took our sons and daughters, all we could do was cry. Why?
And there shall be no might in thine hand.
Do our people got any might in their hand now, bruh? Nah, we don't got no economic might. We don't got no political might. We don't got no military might. We don't even got no financial might. We don't own no banks. Where your economy at, black man? Where your economy at? You don't even got your own economy. He said there ain't gonna be no might in their hand. Give me verse 37. Let me show you that our names was gonna be changed. Read.
Verse 37. And thou shalt become an astonishment.
Astonishment talking about a great wonder. Our nations look at us like a great wonder. They wonder why we love glorifying the poor part of the city. They wonder why we call our women thoughts. They wonder why the black man won't raise the black, I mean won't raise his black kids and take care of his black women. We the only nation of people on earth that won't marry our women. We'll lay down with them, have 2-3 kids by them, but we will not marry them though. The nations look at us and they be like, man, what's wrong with these damn folks? They keep wondering why we ain't prosper as a people yet. They said, look, man, we ain't had them in chains for 100 years now. We had them in chains for 100 years, but why can they not prosper as a people? God said, we're going to what?
And they shall become an astonishment.
Meaning a great wonder, read.
A proverb.
What's a proverb? Proverb is a wise saying. You want to hide something from a nigga? Put it where? Put it in a book.
It's 8:30.
A nigga love chicken.
Go to the front.
A nigga love watermelon.
Okay, okay.
He said, read that again. That should be, could be what?
And thou shalt become an astonishment and a proverb.
A proverb. That's a wise saying. A nigga love chicken. A nigga love great Kool-Aid. A nigga always late. You want to have some from a nigga, put it in a book. A nigga love watermelon. A nigga love great drinks. Them proverbs that you called by, that you known by. Read.
And a byword amongst all nations. Whether the Lord shall lead
you. He's saying a byword. What's a byword? Being called inside, anything outside of what God called you. God called you so-called Negroes Judah. He called you so-called Jamaicans Benjamin. But you called by bywords now. They call you nigga. They call you Negro. They call you African American. You the only nation of people on the planet Earth. Whatever the white man called you, you go back. The white man told you was African American. You say, hey, I'm an African American. I'm an African American. You the only nation of people on the planet Earth that ain't tried to seek out your heritage. Whatever this damn dumb devil taught you, you roll with it. Matthew 26.
I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates from all our YouTube channels. Shalom.